Hello and welcome to Strategy About Gamers, to the Great British Hobbit League YouTube channel, here with your host, GBHL Jamie. And I'm going to be trying to build a Hobbit Hole, as I intend to do some of the Scouring of the Shire scenarios, and I'm going to need some Hobbit Holes to do it. So, I'll be following roughly the instructions from the Scouring in the Shire book. I've got my 2-inch thick styrofoam, it's not styrofoam, is it? It's foam board, I think. I'm going to be cutting into that, and getting this all on camera, so I hope you enjoy it, guys. First things first, I've just cut out a block of the foam board, and I'll be shaping that into the hill and using one of the flat sides as the opening to the Hobbit Hole, I guess. So we'll be back once I have shaped it into a little bit more curved. I'll be using the Stanley knife, and I believe I've got a more exact knife somewhere. So there, be careful when using it. Don't cut yourself. Hopefully I won't. Famous last words, and I'll return once it has been shaped. Welcome back, and there is the hill that I have cut out. I've got the flat side that I'll be cutting into to make the Hobbit Hole door, and I've rounded it off here just to give it a bit of a hill effect, and I did just a little bit more work to get rid of these angular corners and obviously to grade this in a little bit so you can quite clearly see that's a bit flat. So that'll be the next task, and I believe the next step on the instructions is to start making a bit of fencing for it. So I'll be putting it on a base and bringing out a bit here to put in the garden, and that'll be the next task. So I guess once again I'll see you once that's done. Oh, camera's gone out of focus. Good time to end. Welcome back to the Hobbit Hole, and I have rounded off the edges a little bit more and stuck it to its base, and whilst I'm waiting for that to dry, I have created the front for the Hobbit House, which obviously will be neatened up later on and will allow me to cut into and put in sort of the doors and the detail that I want in there. And I'll be moving on to do that now. I'll be doing that with balsa. So I'll be moving rooms and out of the big empty dark room that's about to be decorated. So I am back in front of the computer, and I've got the sort of the basic Hobbit Hole there and the front of it here. And as you can see, I have cut a circle out of the front piece and a circle of balsa and scored it with a pen so that when I paint over it later, I can get some grooves in there and look a bit more like wood. Next step will be to put some windows in here and here and hopefully make some shutters for them. And then maybe a fence of some description going around, but we'll see what I do when I get to it. And I've got my tea, so I'll be eating that, and then I'll come back later on. And here we have a quick update of what's going on. I have cut out two more circles by drawing around the bases, and I forgot to mention earlier that the circle in the middle is obviously just the size of a cavalry base. And I'm going to be using these bases. I'm going to fill in the gaps here, and then use a very thin balsa wood, which I've got here, to cut out and make sort of little window slats, and that will be the next thing that you shall see complete on this project. Windows are now in place, so the sort of the front panel is near enough complete. I need to put a little bit of detail on the door, find some circle for the middle and make a mark for the door handle here, and then I'm gonna attach this to the hill, spray it all brown more than likely, and then paint it. So I'll be back once it's stuck down. I have sanded the front here, and we'll see it once it's brown. Well, now I've sprayed it brown and added in some stepping stones at the front here and sanded the base, and it's literally just been sprayed, so I'm letting it dry, and then I will be putting the flock on top. Sorry, the aerosol's getting on my chest. And here, as I sprayed it, I noticed it looks, well, kind of rubbish to be honest, so I'll be buying some oh, sorry. Spray in the room next to me. Didn't do it outside. I'll be getting some big sort of grassy tufts like this, but obviously green and luscious as the Shire should be. And that will hopefully go along the top, on top of the flock, and come over, and it will cover up sort of the gaps that's left there. Also, I'm going to try and get some of the flowers that people are using at the moment from Element Games and put these in the garden out front. And I should hopefully be doing that later on in the week, so you'll see this completed probably in a flash. So I have now painted it and flopped the majority of the hill itself. So the hobbit hole is looking pretty complete. This would be sort of the semi-finished product. I need to get a few detailed bits that I've not ordered yet, and sort of the door hole, well, the door knob here, the keyhole I want to put in. I need to clean up the windows a little bit. The grass flock has got onto them, and I want to get some flowers for the garden out the front here. And yeah, I think it's looking pretty good. And this is probably the end of the vlog. I will post pictures again on the Twitter feed and the Facebook group once I've got the flowers on, and maybe some stuff on top to break it up just a little bit. It is looking a bit flat there. But that has been my 12th hobby vlog. Hope you've enjoyed it, and I've enjoyed building the hobbit hole. I might build another one for the scenarios, but we do have the one from, I think it's Green Leaf Terrain, that James bought early in the channel's life. So be sure to comment, like, share and subscribe. Support your hobbit hobby, and happy strategy battle gaming, guys.